can involve these guys. And the scary thing was that one kid was taken care of.
What do you mean?
They killed him. Somebody killed him. They grabbed him from someone. They kidnapped him. And when...
I can't hear you.
They wouldn't stop beating on him.
Where did this take place at?
Sacramento.
And where was the boy from?
Sometime I know.
What was his name?
Jeremy.
How do you know his name was Jeremy?
Because I asked him.
And what year was this?
1985.
I can't hear you.
1985.
What time in 1985?
About June.
And how did you get out? And what city were you in now in June 1985?
Sacramento.
And how did you get to Sacramento?
A flight.
I mean, commercial or private?
Private.
And I'm trying not to skip around here, but who did you go out there with?
I went out there that time by myself.
In a private plane? They chartered a private plane just for you yourself?
Oh, I was the only kid that went.
Well, who were
other people? Larry King.
Just you and Larry?
Larry King and me. It was just a small plane. Generally, it was just a single one. And we made several stops on the way out there.
And where did the plane, where did you depart from?
FLA Arizona. And we landed. It was from,
Did you leave from the commercial airline side or from the other side of the airport?
From the other side.
Do you remember?
It was from, I remember. And then we made stops in Grand Island and Denver. Then we stopped in Nevada.
Why would you stop in Grand Island?
We had to pick up some stuff.
What do you mean pick up stuff?
We picked up some camera equipment and stuff. Then we stopped in Denver and picked up some other kid.
Do you remember where you stopped in Grand Island?
We stopped at the airport and we got off and we went down.
Did you take a cab or what?
No. Some guy picked us up in a red Ford pickup. Took us to this hard house and picked up some equipment and went back to the airport for the airplane. Go off with
get the small
Larry King and the pilot that was flying the plane. And had the plane.
Do you remember who the pilot was?
No.
Okay. And then you went to Denver from Grand Island, is that right?
Yeah.
And what'd you do when you got to Denver?
I went into a bar. And we picked up the kid there.
Was the kid already at the airport?
No. We went to a house, we picked him up.
What was his name?
Nicholas.
And how old was he?
He was about 13.
Do you remember where the house was in Aurora?
I think so.
Okay. All right, so then, what was the purpose of picking up Nicholas?
Because he was going to take him out there with us. Phones. The movie that was going to be going on.
Okay, go ahead. Keep going. Right?
After that, we flew and we stopped in Nevada.
Where in Nevada?
Las Vegas.
Okay, and how long were you there?
A few just enough to, I guess, reach you on that.
Scratch. Did you pick up anybody else there?
No.
And then? Yeah. Go ahead.
Then after that, we played a second night. And then we were there, and I met some little Italian guy who was supposed to be some kind of producer. Like a murder guy, producer.
I can't hear you.
Like a murder guy, producer.
Why is that?
Because he's the one that ordered his kid to be killed.
Well, can you be a little more, be a little bit more specific?
Well, they had me and this other kid they picked up in Denver.
You have to speak
and
up.
And they forced us to have sex with this kid, who we didn't even know what they were planning to do with this little
kid. Wait, you and which kid now?
The kid that's from Denver.
Okay. They had you to do what?
Have sex with the boy that they kidnapped. And they were filming this at the time that they told us just to do whatever we wanted and stuff. And so it was all just, everything that he was saying was that it was all just part of the whole thing.
Alright, now how old was this boy that was kidnapped?
About 12.
And how do you know he was kidnapped?
Because they told us.
Who told you?
The little Italian guy that was filming.
Well, why would you believe that what he told you was true? Did the boy say that he was kidnapped?
All the boy was doing was crying. And telling us to not hurt him, to nobody hurt him.
Was he used to having sex?
No.
Did he call out for his mom and dad? I mean, what? Tell me. Get detailed with me here.
No, he began to tell us to just start with each other and start playing. So I put him in there with us.
But who is where?
The boy.
Which is where? Take your time. Take your time.
Put us in a cage.
Are you in a house or are you in a hotel?
We were wooded area. We were inside of the wooded dog. We're outside of the woods.
Okay, now let me back up. You arrived in Sacramento.
Yeah.
Where did you go when you got there?
We went to a hotel.
Okay, when you say we,
that's another team, the boy, me, and guy who flew us there.
Okay, do you remember what hotel?
No.
Okay, do you remember what year?
It was 1985.
Yeah, what month do you remember? Yeah, we need to look at the 1985 calendar right here.
About September. Just after school.
Okay, now how old were you then?
I was about 18 at that time.
Okay. Alright. So you go to a hotel. Tell me, just take me all the way through it now.
Okay, we got off the plane and we went to the hotel and we checked in, put all of our stuff in our room, and then now we got on the phone and we called somebody and they told us they'd be there and they'd to pick us up and take us out to somewhere. I didn't hear the whole conversation, and then about a half hour later some guy came up. Knocked on the door, and stuff, and went out. We got into big stretch limo that we had to pick us up and went out. And we drove about half hour, 45 minutes, and we drove outside the city limits, and we drove into a kind of a tree area. There was a lot of trees and stuff.
Weren't you scared?
No.
You weren't scared?
No, I wasn't scared because... I mean, I was. I was scared until after I got there.
What about Nicholas? Was he scared?
Yeah.
Why didn't you guys leave? Why didn't you guys run? You had opportunity to leave, didn't you?
Yeah.
Why didn't you go tell somebody?
I didn't know what was going on until we got there.
Well, but you, I mean, when you... Okay, go ahead.
Once we got there, we didn't know what was going on. We got there and they told us they were filming, they're just going to make a movie. And I've already been out there about 3 dozen times. We got filming movies, had sex with guys or other boys this time.
Same place?
One time I was in the same place.
Same producer?
No, I didn't. And I didn't think anything bad about it, nothing ever had gone wrong before. Nothing like this anymore. And they started this planning, and they started telling us what to say and what to do.
Who would say what to do?
This little time guy. He gave us his lines and stuff. He says, all you have to do is say what you feel. Frankly, he says, he wants it to be, look natural. And everything you... He says, just go with what you feel. So I just want to, get you guys filming, here. And they gave us these things like, called Tarzan, of course, they had him in a cage and stuff.
Yeah, who was the kid?
The kid. The kid that...
Was he crying? Yeah. At that point? That's all he did was cry the whole time? They didn't knock... Did anybody ever slap him and tell him to quit crying?
Yeah, they slapped him a lot.
And did he quit crying?
He started to, and then I started talking to him and telling him it was going to be alright and that we weren't, nobody's going to hurt him. I tried to tell him nobody was going to hurt him, but he never believed me. And after a while, I didn't believe him. But they had us, they took him out of the cage and stuff, and they let him run. We were supposed to chase him down.
How big of a cage were you
in? Probably about 5 by 5 feet.
So it was just a small cage?
A small cage.
And when you say we, who are you talking about?
Me and another kid, remember.
Nicholas?
Nicholas. They let him out of the cage.
Yeah, how many people were present?
It was me, Nicholas, the boy, another kid, the pilot.
Pilot was there too?
The pilot was there too. Producer, and there was about 4 other people there that were filming this. And what they had us do is they had their camera set up so they let him out so he could run. And they had us chase him down. They told us we were supposed to chase him down and then we were supposed to drag him back. We were both bigger than he was to run. And so we drug him down after he started running. We drug him around and stuff.
Whoa. How far did you chase him?
About 20 feet.
That's it?
I don't know that fast.
Okay, so you caught him and what did you do? Knock him down or what?
Knocked him down and we drug him back up to where the cage is at and stuff.
How did you drag him?
I grabbed his legs and then he grabbed his arm and just sort of kind of carried him back up, kind of grinding with it.
Was he kicking, screaming?
He was kicking and screaming. And
what was he saying?
Saying, please don't hurt me.
Did you hurt him, Paul? What'd you do to him, Paul?
I did not get home in the room.
Where did they paint the room fall?
I slept with him.
Okay. Now you were used to having sex with people, right? Something else must have happened then. When did it fall?
I was just crying and I was telling him. I told the guys, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do this. They're like, do it or else, or we'll finish you too. Who's telling you this, Paul? God is directing this thing. Does he mean to do this, or we'll kill you too?
Do what, Paul? Do what?
Screw the kid.
Okay, so you screwed the kid, then what happened? Did Nicholas screw the kid too?
Yeah.
Something you're not telling me, Paul.
Yeah, that's some other guy came in and we didn't even know about it. And Nicholas didn't know what was going to go on next. This guy came in and started kicking the shit out of me because they started trying to kick the shit out of me. He started beating on the kid.
Who started beating on me?
This guy that was with the dog crew stuff. He came in and started having sex with this kid.
Okay.
Bleeding.
Bleeding from where?
Right there.
Okay. You okay?
And then this guy dragged him around.
Are you in the cage?
Started dragging him around. He took a thing. He was dragging the kid around. He was still having sex with him. He was tossing his foot around like that.
That is pretty dope.
He was tossing his kid around like he was a bag of potatoes or something. He started slamming them all over the place. Then he came back and he started kicking the shit out of me again. Started kicking my head. I started doing something to hit with a stick. I had to fall and then fight him back. Then he took me and Nicholas and shoved us in the cage. Then he took this kid and he sat there and sat him up.
Sat him up?
Right next to the cage, ready. I kept telling, yo, the guy saw me, I said, kill him if I got a hold of him. I said, no, he just shot him.
You what?
Shot him. Shot him in his head. Right after that, I tried to kill myself. Took his back a little top and tried to cut my wrist.
Who shot him in the neck, Paul? Did you shoot him with a pistol or a rifle?
Pistol.
Where exactly did they shoot him on his body?
Cut his head.
Front and behind?
The front.
coach is crying so much after they did that stuff, they opened the cage, they grabbed Nicholas, and they scared me to death, so they took him and they drug him over into the woods and stuff, and I heard a couple of shots. I thought they killed him too. They didn't.
They put Nicholas out of the cage? And they drug him over to the... to where?
Drug him off into some trees or something. I thought they'd shot him, but they didn't. And they said that he came back and they... One guy came back and he Nicholas didn't come back and stuff. I didn't see him until about an hour later. They had him cuffed up. He was scared to death.
What did they do with the body?
I don't know.
Did you see him drag him away?
I saw him pick it up. Put it in the car. I saw it curve right away. That's my car.
What did Larry King do throughout all this?
He was watching it. Smiling.
Smiling. Why didn't you report them? You never told anybody until this day about that? I
told my friends about it.
You told the police about it?
Yeah.
Who did you tell the police?
Detective Pope.
What did he say?
He didn't believe me.
Why?
Says those type of things just don't happen. Just like he says that this type of stuff doesn't happen in Omaha. Omaha was a nice conservative town.
You weren't in Omaha.
I know. He's like everything else in this that I could tell him. These type of things don't happen in Omaha. People from Omaha don't do that stuff.
Happened to you, didn't it?
Yes.
So what happened after?
How much later after the gunshot
and the boy was killed did you leave?
3 hours.
Describe the setting for me, please.
Wooded area with a clearing. It looked like there was a garden off to one direction. There was a house that was not too far from there that I believe that the producer or somebody lived at. But that's where we lived after we left there. In this clearing there was some rocks and big boulders, like cage was like set in between and they had like clubs there for us, like caveman clubs and stuff, and they had this picture of a couple of dinosaurs and stuff that were right there too. And the room that led up there was kind of, it was a closed room, and all the trees were pretty big, just a wooded area, and a swing, you know, a little like pond or something down in one of the troughs. The house, there was a swimming pool shaped like a
kind of a half moon sort of shape.
Tell me a little more about the boy that was murdered.
He had blonde hair and brown eyes.
About how old was he?
Somewhere around 12. I know he's from Idaho.
And again, how do you know he was from Idaho?
Because that's something he had mentioned.
The boy himself? And did he have a first name?
All I think is there's something. I don't know.
Try to remember.
Term. Shape.
Can you say where in Idaho he's from?
No, he never got that out. You guys kept telling me to shut up, and I was trying to talk to him. So I was trying to calm him down. I was trying to tell him that nothing was going to happen to him. That everything would be all right.
You ever experienced anything like that before?
No. Just 84, my best friend killed himself.
Pardon?
Just in 1984, my best friend killed himself.
But I mean, when somebody was murdered like that?
Not that I had seen. So I heard about it.
Any other identifying features you can remember about the boy?
He had two bones right here, two silver parts. Both ones on the back of his teeth, and he had braces.
The fillings on the upper or lower?
On the upper.
And how do you remember that?
Because I remember when I was young stuff that I was sawing.
Did they make you beat him?
They tried to.
Did you?
Not really.
Well, what does that mean, not really?
I act like I was hitting him, but I really wasn't. The other martial arts had pull punches and stuff, and I was just barely hit him and stuff.
Tell me this. You were in martial arts. Why did you use your martial arts against some of these other people?
I was scared. I didn't know what to do if I did. I mean, they had guns and I didn't.
Do you think Larry King knew who this boy was?
Yeah.
Why do you think he did?
Because he was the one responsible for bringing this out there.
Would he be responsible for this other boy?
I don't know.
Probably.
Why else would he fly us out there for killing something?
Was this boy already there when you got there?
Yes.
Whatever happened to Nicholas?
As far as I know, it is in Colorado still.
Do you remember his last name?
No.
Do you know how we could find him?
No, I hadn't heard from him.
When's the last time you heard from him?
That was it. Sometimes I've never seen him.
So after this incident took place and you left the area, where did you go?
Back to the hotel for the night and we flew back here.
Did the pilot take part in any sex?
Yes.
Well, tell me about it. I mean, did he out there or back here or?
Out there in the hotel room that night with me.
What was his name?
I don't remember.
Nothing you can recall?
All I know is he flies out of, he flies for, he's a pilot for like news tractor.
Is he still out there?
I think so. I believe so.
Do you remember first name, anything? Can you describe him?
He was a tall kind of a brownish blonde hair. And
is he white or black?
He's white. He had one brown eye and one blue eye. He had a scar on his left arm right here, went all the way down. He said he had a surgery or something, and he had a tattoo on his chest right here of an eagle. And he was always talking about the Air Force and stuff. He's talking about how he spent so many years in the Air Force and stuff. And he'd been in the Air Force for like 10 years or so. He was a captain or something. The pilot thing.
When's the last time you've seen him?
About 1986, at a party. About the last time I went to a party, I imagine party. It's like a lot of guys I never asked him their names because, I don't know, I just kind of feel like a prostitute. I never asked anybody their names. I never really care as long as I got the money.
Didn't this incident with this boy bother you?
Yeah.
And you still kept seeing?
No, I stopped seeing where I came altogether. I mean, I didn't want anything to do with him again, but I got away from all those people in April 1986. Getting involved with these guys. The thing that scared me the most is one kid was taken care of.
What do you mean?
They killed him. Somebody killed him. They grabbed him from someone. They kidnapped him. And when...
I can't hear you.
They wouldn't stop beating on him.
Where did this take place at?
Sacramento.
And where was the boy from?
Sometimes I know. We had stopped in Grand Island in Denver. Then we stopped in Nevada.
Why would you stop in Grand Island?
We had to pick up some stuff.
What do you mean pick up stuff?
We picked up camera equipment. Then we stopped in Denver and picked up some other kid.
Do you remember where you stopped in Grand Island?
We stopped at the airport and we got off and we got
in. Did you take a cab or what?
No. Some guy picked us up in a red Ford pickup. Took us to this farmhouse also picked up some equipment and went back there for the airport.
A plane? They chartered a private plane just for you yourself?
Oh, I was the only kid that went.
Well, who were
other Larry King.
Just you and Larry?
Larry King and me. It was just a small plane. It wasn't generally more just a single one. And we made several stops on the way out there.
And where did the plane, where did you depart from?
Eppley, Arizona. And we landed. It was from,
Did you leave from the commercial airline side or from the other side of the airport?
From the other side.
Do you remember?
It was from the... I don't remember.
What was his name?
Jeremy.
How do you know his name was Jeremy?
Because I asked him.
And what year was this?
1985.
I can't hear you.
1985.
What time in 1985?
About June.
And how did you get out? And what city were you in now in June 1985?
Sacramento.
And how did you get to Sacramento?
A flight.
I mean, commercial or private?
Private.
And I'm trying not to skip around here, but who did you go out there with?
I went out there that time by myself.
In a private?
So often.
Get the small
one. Larry Keegan was the pilot that was flying the plane. Pilots are flying.
You remember who the pilot was?
No.
Okay. And then you went to Denver from Grand Island, is that right?
Yeah.
And what did you do when you got to Denver?
I went into a bar. I went to check out the kid there.
Was the kid already at the airport?
No. I went to a house. They picked him up.
What was his name?
Nicholas.
And how old was he?
He was about 13.
Do you remember where the house was in Aurora?
I think so.